can they take the Buccaneers off the air? It's the greatest show ever.
I don't know, Nattie, but it's gone.
What, the Buccaneers is gone? That's not possible.
Read it in a week, Sidney. They put on some show called Perry Mason.
What the hell is that? Perry Mason.
Raymond Burr stars as defense attorney Perry Mason, solving murder mysteries with the aid of his personal investigator, Paul Drake, and his devoted secretary, Della Street.
They took the Buccaneers off for a defense attorney?
What a chip.
I can't believe this. No more adventures on the high seas. No more Blackbeard, the pirate.
No more swashbuckling.
The Buccaneers was an outstanding program. How can they do this?
Well, maybe this Perry Mason guy show will be good.
I don't care if it's good. The Buccaneers was great.
We can't sit idly by and watch this happen. I'm going to write a letter. Tell them to bring the Buccaneers back.
That's a great idea. I'll write a letter, too, and I'll sign it in blood like Captain Dan Tempest.
Good idea, Nady.
Aye, aye. Hoist the anchor. Trim the mainsail. Set course for a new Providence.
Kid loves that show.
Yep. He's a little nuts, but he loves that show.
The streets where we play, the friends on every corner were the best we ever made. The backyards and the schoolyards and the trees that watched us grow. The days of love when dinner time was all you had to know. Whenever I think of yesterday, that place just over the Brooklyn Bridge, that will always be home to me. It'll always be home to me.
Here's the rest of the good china. Now you'll be very impressive for your big fancy dinner.
I'm not trying to impress anybody. Cut it out.
Don't think I don't remember the way you were with this Susan Lowenberg in school. Who wears the fanciest dresses? Who gets the best grades? Who shoots the most goals in the football games? I remember.
That's not true. We were best friends.
So why the fancy dinner?
We haven't seen each other in a long time, that's all. I want it to be special.
What's so special about dinner out of a book?
It's not a book. It's Better Homes and Gardens.
Better than what? Why don't you let me cook dinner downstairs? Susan can eat with us.
I've explained this to you 100 times, Ma.
Well, try one more. Maybe not so smart.
I haven't seen Susan in years. I haven't even met her husband. We're going to have a lot of catching up to do. I don't want you and Dad and the kids to be bored.
What? I never met Susan. I might not want to catch up a little.
Ma.
Oh, I know what it is. You're ashamed of me. You want to put me in the closet and pretend I'm dead.
Will you stop it? I'll bring Susan by your apartment. We'll all say hi. You can catch up. I just want to have a grown-up dinner party with my old friend. Is that all right with you?
No, it's not.
How does this sound, Allie? Dear sirs, please, 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 please bring back the Buccaneers. All my friends watch it. It's the greatest. I like the swashbuckling adventure, and I fear that Perry Mason may not feature enough pirates. Signed, Nathaniel Silver. P.S. Long live the Buccaneer.
Sounds pretty good, Nady.
I figure if I write a letter to them every day, they've got to bring the Buccaneers back, don't you think?
Well, it can't hurt. Shouldn't you be getting dressed? Mom's friend's going to be here pretty soon.
I know. We're supposed to be presentable. I wish I had a pirate hat I could wear.
Is it?
They'll be here any minute. Do we have any vermouth?
Vermouth? God, no.
Well, what do we do if they want a Rob Roy?
What's a Rob Roy?
Cocktail right here, Scotch whiskey and vermouth. A dry Rob Roy is made with dry vermouth and a sweet one's made with sweet vermouth.
What kind do you make with no vermouth?
How's it going in the kitchen?
It's fine, I guess. You know, I'm actually a little nervous. We don't do this very often. Have a couple over for dinner.
Phil, we never do this.
Well, that's not very often.
Don't worry. It'll go fine. It's just good old Susan Lowenberg. I mean, what could go wrong?
Well, who's to say she's still good old Susan Lowenberg? You haven't seen her in, what, almost 10 years?
People don't change. We haven't. Her husband will
probably be a very nice guy. We'll have a good dinner. It'll be fun.
He's very successful, you know. Ed Jones?
I know. He owns a TV station. You told me. That'll be interesting. That's something we can talk about.
Yeah, and we can talk about Brooklyn. I mean, my God, she hasn't been here much in the last 10 years. We can catch her up. Talk about, you know, Brooklyn things, the Dodgers.
The bridge.
Listen to us. It's like we're going out on a date. This is just an old friend and her husband coming over. It's nothing to be nervous about. We don't have to impress them or anything. Let's take the plastic off the sofa.
Husband's very successful.
I know, you told me.
He owns a television station.
I know, you told me.
Hey, maybe you should talk to him about the Buccaneers, Nattie.
Ma! Ma, look who's here.
Susan, look at
oh, Mrs.
you.
Mrs. Burger.
How dare you grow up and be even more beautiful.
Oh, it's so good to see you. It's been too long. Hello, Mr. Burger.
How are you?
This is my husband, Ed.
How do you do, sir?
Great.
Hello, pleasure. Mrs. Burger. How are you? Nice to meet you.
Oh, and here are the boys, Al and Nathaniel.
Hi.
Hello, Mrs. Jones.
Oh, boy, did you two grow up.
How's it going, sport?
How you doing, sir?
So, who needs what? Little something to eat, or...
We're just gonna go ahead, go upstairs and have a cocktail, Ma. We'll pop our heads in before we go.
Everything okay down here, guys?
Oh, everything's great, sport.
How about that cocktail there, George?
Coming up. What can I get for you?
A gin and tonic, please, George.
And for you, Ed?
How about a scotch and soda?
There's no vermouth in that, is there?
If there is, you're fired.
Here, I'll throw these in the bedroom. I'll come with you, freshen up. We can talk about these big, handsome men behind their backs. Unbelievable.
Nothing's changed, Phil. Never does.
Your mom looks great. She looks exactly the same. She's still running the neighborhood?
Sure. Your mom's the same way. I guess the whole generation is.
Drives me completely insane. Oh, the minute we walked into the house this afternoon, my mother was trying to force feed her sponge cake to poor Ed. And Dad kept telling Ed he looked like this relative and that relative. Then they started yelling at each other in Yiddish. It was enough to drive you to a psychiatrist. It did drive me to a psychiatrist.
You're joking, right?
Dr. Minerman, Thursdays at 1. The doctor's gonna get an earful about this little trip home, I can tell you that. George looks great. He's still at the post office?
Mm-hmm. Nights, mostly.
Oh, he's been there forever.
I'm still on insurance. I switched companies.
You're still working. I don't know how you do it. I mean, we have two boys in boarding school, and I could still never work. Oh, forget it. That's one Ed could never put up with.
He seems nice.
He does seem nice, doesn't he?
You mean he's not nice?
What kind of question is that, Dr. Minerman?
We don't have to talk about this. You just got here.
Oh, no, no, it's not a problem or anything. Ed is in a very high-pressured profession. There's a lot of pressure. And we do a lot of entertaining in the home, and Ed likes things to be, well, perfect. And I understand that. And everything is perfect most of the time. It really is. I don't even know what I'm saying. Everything's fine. My life is fine. And God knows I love Cleveland.
You've already been over to Susan's mom's place, I guess.
Oh, yeah, sure. She must have 20 photos of us up there in the living room alone.
Yeah, Phyllis's mom's the same way.
I have not seen so many pictures of myself since my bar mitzvah. And then she reads us the riot act about not seeing her enough, of course. Same thing every time we see her. She says we wouldn't know if she dropped off the face of the earth. You'd think we never visited the old gal.
When was the last time you came to Brooklyn?
Oh, about 10 years ago, I guess. But she was out to see us at the house less than 5 years ago, maybe 6. Oh, in-laws, they'll drive you crazy, quick as a blink.
Wow.
What am I telling you for? You live right on top of yours. You poor son of a gun.
So, are you originally from Cleveland?
No, we moved there after I bought WCVD, the TV station there. But we love it. It's a great town.
How about those Indians, huh?
What Indians?
The Cleveland Indians. The baseball team.
Oh, the ball team. Yeah. Are they good? I don't know. I don't follow sports much. I don't have the time, or the interest, actually. Never really liked sports. I just don't really enjoy all that sports stuff. Well, anyway,
Ladies! Let me get your drink, Susan.
It is so nice of you to have us over, Phyllis. I am looking forward to a good square meal. Susan here keeps experimenting with all that gourmet crap.
I took a course.
A cooking course?
From a bona fide Frenchman, right, Sue?
He was a cordon bleu graduate.
Yippee.
I did it because you said you were sick of chicken.
So now I'm sick of Meunier and Béarnaise.
There we go. Gin and tonic.
Thank you, George.
Oh, that's dinner. Why don't you all sit down? Dinner will be on the table in no time.
Shall we sit?
Oh, yeah.
Good, good.
Thank you. Honey, why don't you open it?
My pleasure, darling.
Can I help with anything? Is that cooked?
I forgot to turn the oven on.
Oh, okay.
Ed, Susan, I've just got to run down to Mom's to grab something. I'll be right back.
Sophie, this smells delicious.
Oh.
What are you doing?
I forgot to turn the oven on upstairs. I'm stealing your dinner.
What?
You can all go get Chinese. My treat.
Yay!
Please, Mom, this is an emergency.
You see? This is what happens when you don't do what your mother tells you.
We sometimes use Sophie's oven downstairs. It's more, it's got a better, cooker.
Oh.
Ta-da!
Oh, my. Oh, that looks great.
Let's eat.
Did you get extra fortune cookies, Grandma?
Of course.
Good, because I want to find out what's going to happen to the Buccaneers.
I want to find out what's going to happen to the New York Knicks.
I want to find out what's going on upstairs with the Joneses.
Sophie, nothing is going on. They're having a nice dinner, that's all.
They're having our dinner.
Grandma, you came through in an emergency. You should feel good.
I should feel good. My own daughter wants to eat dinner without the rest of the family.
They have things to talk about.
What kind of things?
I don't know. Just things.
Maybe they're talking about the Buccaneers.
You go to the city much? Manhattan? Sometimes I grab an afternoon in the mailroom at a building on Wall Street, a weekend shift.
I meant to eat or see a show.
Oh.
No, not that often. We should go in more.
Is she the show West Side Story that's playing now? Susan loved it.
Leonard Bernstein, it's brilliant.
I fell asleep.
You always fall asleep. Did you see it?
Not yet, no.
Susan's mom. Here she is living a 10-minute cab ride from the Great White Way for 40 years. You know how many times she's been into the city in all that time? Zero times.
Well, they're more comfortable staying in the neighborhood.
Susan's mom is more comfortable staying in the apartment. She last saw the sun in 1944.
Ed.
Terrific brisket, Phyllis.
Delicious. And this is delicious wine. Thank you for bringing it.
Thanks for having us.
It's so good to see you, Phyllis.
It really is. It just brings back so many memories.
We did have some fun, didn't we?
Am I dreaming? Or were we the smartest, the prettiest, and the most interesting people in school?
That's how I remember it. And if you don't believe it, just ask our mothers. I'm sure that's how they remember it, too.
I'd like to make a toast. Welcome back to the old neighborhood. And here's to seeing good old friends.
Oh.
Here, here.
Cheers.
That is good wine. Did you pick that wine, Ed?
You always pick the wine, Susan.
I picked a hell of a wine.
Oh.
What's going on up there?
Sophie, please, sit down and stop worrying.
Why haven't they come down to see us?
They're having dinner. Let them have dinner.
Why don't you take a little trip up there and see what's doing?
You mean spy?
I mean look.
You mean spy?
Okay, spy.
Sophie, stop it. Leave Phyllis and George alone with their friends.
I didn't even know Mom and Dad had friends.
No, I wouldn't mind having a look at Mom and Dad having a dinner party. It'd be kind of like seeing wild animals out of their natural habitat.
Here's what you do. You walk in, very nice, casual. You say you need one more game out of your room. You come back down, you tell me everything you see.
Grandma, I'm surprised at you.
What, that I'm asking you to snoop?
No, you're not doing this yourself.
So tell us a little more about your TV station, Ed. That sounds so glamorous.
Hollywood on Lake Erie.
You ever meet any movie stars?
Sid Caesar came through last year. So did Gleason.
You met Jackie Gleason?
We had a drink with him.
Susan, you had a drink with Jackie Gleason?
A couple of drinks.
What do you say to a guy like Gleason? To the moon?
No, I think you say, lose some weight.
Boys.
Boys. Is everything okay downstairs?
Oh, just great. We came up to get another game.
Out of our room. That's why we came up here.
Oh, okay.
So what do you think?
Well, it is a little weird.
How long do we stay in here?
I think we have to stay for a few minutes to make it look natural. While we're here, we might as well listen.
Your boys are so sweet, Phyllis.
Thanks. I wish you'd brought yours. How old is William now?
He's 17. Can you believe it? And Daniel's 14. They grow up fast, don't they?
I'll say, one day they're crawling around in a crib, you turn around, they're in high school.
We're gonna go up and see our boys in 2 weeks.
Where are they?
Up at Deerfield, in Massachusetts.
Boarding school?
Right. They love it. Well, they don't love it. It's been a little tough on Daniel. It's his first year up there, but he'll learn to love it.
You can imagine how my mother feels about boarding school. If our boys went away to school, I think my mother would go back to the old country.
We thought Susan's parents would get right back on the boat, too. Didn't work.
Oh, Ed, please. He loves to tease me about my mother. His mother's not so different.
To tell the truth, I think boarding school has been more difficult on Susan than it's been on the boys.
Well, you must miss them so much.
No, it's not that. It's just that Susan has nothing to do.
Except entertain Ed?
Well, I've tried to think of a hobby or something for her, but she just doesn't like to do anything.
It's nothing you know about.
Do you folks have any ideas? I mean, what did you two do when you were in school together?
Well, we did everything, right, Sue?
That's right.
What? I'd really like to know. What did you do?
We had fun, Ed. Do you remember fun? That's what we did. Right, Phyllis?
Oh, damn it. I spilled my wine. I'm sorry.
It's nothing. Let me get you another glass.
What do you think he's doing up there?
I don't know, but I don't think you can see through the ceiling.
We should go up.
We should go up. Sophie, what for?
To make sure the boys are okay.
The boys are fine.
Then why didn't they come back downstairs?
Maybe the Joneses are nice people and they're talking to them.
Well, if they're so nice, why aren't they talking to us? I'm going up.
Sophie,
I'm
please.
I'm worried. What are they doing up there?
They live up there.
They were supposed to come back down here. They haven't even opened their fortune cookies.
Sophie, please don't make me put my foot down. Phyllis and George are having a dinner party with the Joneses. Let's leave them alone. They're having a wonderful time. Oh,
God. Maybe I just don't find your interests interesting, Ed.
You sure find my charge accounts interesting.
Less and less, Ed. Less and less.
There we go. I think that'll come out.
Oh, yeah, definitely. That is going to come out.
Do you remember the time I ripped my dress at that dance at Lafayette and you had the sewing kit in your purse?
And I have plenty of interests, Ed, just because I refuse to play golf.
I'm just trying to be helpful, dear.
Well, you're striking out, honey.
You sewed that thing right up, right there in the girls' room.
That was Belinda Schneider, not me.
Really?
And what the hell
Mr. and Mrs. Jones are fighting, aren't they?
They sure are.
Should we go up to Grandma's?
I'm not going out there. Paul Westberg isn't my friend. Boy, that's a real fight.
I guess this would be a bad time to go ask him about the Buccaneers, huh? This isn't the
peace. Peace? You mean place.
This is not a good idea, Sophie.
What? We just say hello. What's so terrible?
I'm not sitting back down if you're going to behave like this.
Like what? Oh, my God, Ed, this is so embarrassing.
Why don't we just go?
We can't go. This is my oldest friend.
We're going.
We don't go when you decide to go. We go when we decide to go. We're a couple.
Get your coat.
Such an awful man.
Well, for God's sake, Susan, don't make a scene.
It's a little late to worry about making a scene.
Is this why you dragged me to Brooklyn so you could embarrass me in front of your friends?
I didn't drag you anywhere. What's so terrible about going to see my mother every 10 years?
Do you really want me to answer that?
That's enough.
It's never enough.
So maybe they're not having a wonderful time.
Just get it.
Maybe we should make a run for it.
I'm getting it.
I don't think so. I think it's best to just stay right here.
It's over, all right? We'll just go.
Boy, why would anybody ever want to go to a dinner party?
I'm so sorry.
Hey, if you have to go, you have to go.
We promised Susan's mother we'd drop by and say hi. Boy, I'm sure glad we remembered, huh, Sue?
We didn't promise anything to my mother, Ed. We're fighting. These are not stupid people. They can see that.
All right, Susan, that's enough. Why don't we just pay the check and get out of here?
Pay the check?
I'll get the cab.
I'll walk down with you.
No, please. We're fine. Thank you. And thank you very much for dinner. It was very nice to meet you. Mm-hmm. Susan?
I'd like to say goodbye to Phyllis. I'll be down in a minute. We've been under a lot of stress, you know. I'm sorry, Phyllis.
It's okay.
We're not quite as crazy as we seem, really. We're close, but... You'll come to Cleveland someday. We'll have you over and everything will be much smoother, I promise.
Okay.
Oh,
Mrs. Berger, Mr. Berger, good night. It was so nice to see you.
Good night.
We'll be right back.
I feel so sorry for anybody who's that sad.
Me too.
She was such a happy teenager. We really did have a lot of fun.
I'm telling you, that's what happens to people who leave the neighborhood.
I'm never leaving.
Of course you're not.
So you're saying if we just stay here in this building, we'll all live happily ever after?
And why not?
Well, nobody could accuse you of being narrow-minded, Grandma.
Hey, you guys got extra fortune cookies.
Of course.
Ready? Go!
You are wise beyond your years.
Well, I got plenty of years. I must be very wise.
You will steer children down the road to enlightenment. Uh-oh. Fasten your seatbelts, guys. What's yours, Alan?
There are seven seas. You will see them all.
Fine. As long as you're home for dinner.
What's yours say, Nattie?
Confucius say all good things travel in a circle. What's that mean?
Well, it sounds like Confucius thinks the Buccaneers is coming back. What about yours, Dad?
The simple song is the sweetest song.
Oh, that's so nice.
What's yours say, Grandma?
Look, mine's in Chinese. But I think I know what it says.
Really? What's it say, Grandma?
It says, no one is as lucky as Sophie Berger to have you all for my family. No one is so lucky as me.